In a right position would felt even better because it's a bit tilted, maybe but still you feel fine.
Mm-hmm.
Ah.
No, it's not. They're not sarcophagus. Why bother to make it so nice and comfortable if somebody's dead?
Felt nice in the body.
This is our location, and we'll just have a look at the ruins around here.
Too small for people.
Okay.
For people.
Having a look through here.
Yeah.
In the rock.
And they are on top of the rock. Good, I don't even have any focuses. Does anybody have actual focuses?
Agriculture? That's the only thing that's really occurred to me.
Growing rice?
Maybe. They grow rice?
No, because the rice, they need to flood the...
Yeah, you know. I mean, that's the only reason I hadn't said anything is because I couldn't think of a plant to put in something like this. But rice?
Mm-hmm.
But it would be larger.
A continuation of the footage here. And then this rock just sits out here, so we'll just bound across, and this rock is just right out there. It's a huge drop down and around. Where's Sylvie there? Here is another look.
Not enough to say that which one is normal, the straight or the slant. I don't know.
There's some kind of, I don't know if these are tunnels.
Yeah, that's good.
And some have for the head, the others don't have for the head.
Yeah, it's worn out.
Okay, so they've got to be really important because they wouldn't be carved out of this hard-ass rock unless they were really important.
And they're at every major location.
Exactly. So maybe some sort of like industry, like food production. I mean, these are churches. Monks make liquor. I mean, not liquor, but beer, like wine. I don't know. I'm just...
You open, because over there we see all those parts of room. Maybe this was just the floor and there was a ceiling. So there was no problem with the water.
Hmm.
And then you could use it maybe for anything.
Yeah.
I mean, you can put a shrunken mummy indeed inside.
Yeah, it's been dismantled. We saw the other one on top of the little swimming pool. And yet all the blocks around, he had a seat in that thing.
But do you think the floor, like this was the place. Floor? The rough rock floor like this inside a building?
No, rough.
Could be.
It could have.
Worn out. It's all worn out.
Just, that was just a
otherwise,
question.
Otherwise, it's only good for rice like this. I don't see anything else.
It's all worn out. Especially the surface. See.
Yeah, this is all worn out.
So much worn out. So you see only the level of the wall up there. You could see the level that from the swimming pool pass through one level of... let's say body fitting shapes here of these holes, and went to the first, second, third level, and all the little canals were leading the water easily.
Well, the only time when the canals would work is when the pool was full anyway.
Ah, exactly. But where is the pool here? It's all submerged.
I mean, if they had
here somewhere,
if they had all the standing water under their floor or at the bottom, I mean, it would just be a terrible bug and stench problem.
Exactly.
You know?
It was running water. It was either from a little cricket around here. Or they brought it, I mean, I don't know if it's any river, whatever. How do you call it in English?
You said
stream.
Creek.
Creek. So not cricket.
Cricket.
It's a little insect.
Bug.
Okay, bug. Yeah. No, so, yeah. A little stream of water they brought here. Or... you can do it dry without water because either. You could see there is a little hole that you can empty the those.
But very few have a hole.
Yeah, so it's not consistent.
No, none of it is consistent.
So for a bit more context here, the crew had been the New Earth group or crew, as I sort of call them, because Sylvie ran it and she runs the New Earth channel on YouTube. This was about our fourth day getting about Italy at these historic sites, and we'd seen other instances prior to this of these rock cut human shaped like prominences into the rock, coffin like and indeed that's what they simply may be, and perhaps all of them, but they may have further uses as well. I'd just like to point out that I noticed an instance of these in England at Heysham. So we would be based in Italy here, but up here in England, you have another instance also. Wow, so this is rocks. So here is the example of the triptych configuration, and without having been in here before, again all these recesses into the floor. In this case, in many cases, there is this this step down part before it goes into the main chamber. Again here, although they're not consistent heights, but there is a step down part as if you could put a covering on here. It's, yes, in here, step down part, and in here, a step down part. There's a bone down here from probably human. Joking about that. And,
no. Yeah, it could be, you know, these like maybe something holding something, you know, like closing something.
Oh, yeah.
You know?
Yeah. Along here.
Like rings.
So yeah.
Metal ring.
Yeah. Yeah.
Something.
All right, so this one here. In this case, there is a triangular form. Now, one thing about this little area, and I'm traversing these things and trying not to fall in, is that you can see the finish, then you can see this area here, which may have been to lay things across with this prominence here, and it sort of comes across here, and then you go down one, and then it's like there's a second layer. There could be a second layer in here. Now, next up, one of the crew, Daniel, has put together a bit of audio with his thoughts on what these human-shaped, in many cases, cuttings might be for into the rock. And indeed, there may be something to that. I made some noise within there, and with the stone so close to your ears, you really do get this real resonance when you are there and making noise and lying within these rock cuts. Just as far as rice goes, I think that with rice patties and all the rest of it, with rice, that it wasn't like officially rice didn't wasn't grown in Europe until something like the Middle Ages, something like that. But of course, it may have been before that also. But nonetheless, let's now listen to Daniel speak. I will show some of his photographs as well as further photographs and footage of my own. And in there will be comments. So enjoy.
One of the things we occasionally saw during this expedition to Italy were these coffin-like recesses carved into the rock. These were one of the more fascinating things for me. As for the purpose of them, I can't say for sure. Some members of the group theorized they were ceremonial baths, like for baptism, or vibroacoustics, which has to do with sound and vibration. And I guess burial tombs was the official story. Personally, I don't think they were made for the dead. I think they were made for the living, at least in the beginning. These recesses have a kind of human-like shape to them with one narrowed end, and some in the group found it inviting to lay inside. Laying in one myself, the first thing I noticed was just this immediate shift in perception of my surroundings. It affects your hearing in a way that draws your attention upwards. I could hear the wind in the trees and the birds above very clearly. The people talking all around me just sort of receded into the background. And you're left with this feeling of being very in tune with nature. There's this deep sense of calm that washes over you. A sense of oneness. Basically, it was a state one normally would get through meditation. Only this seemed to switch on that state instantly and without effort. So one other possibility we could add is that these could have been for a form of meditation, or altering states of consciousness, for healing or accessing deeper levels of oneself, maybe to improve mental faculties, for creative problem solving, or spiritual growth, and so on. And lately I've been thinking that they could have had different uses by different people at different time periods. For example, an ancient civilization using them for vibroacoustic or meditative practices, then being reused later by medieval people for baptismal ceremony. Most of the members of our group did agree there were at least two layers of civilization there, one medieval and one much older, and only a few of these recesses had the drainage holes, so who knows, these could have been modifications done at a later time. But speculation aside, I would like to see further research done, particularly monitoring the brainwave states of people before and after laying inside. That would be something very interesting for me.
I found a bench.
So we're back at the start.
Back. Now that we've gone all the way up,
and
this one has
just looking
view.
More closely at this,
this one
in this area here, the lines of it both curve around like that, and this section is squarish.
It was easy to come here, they did all the math.
Such curious structures. A look at the scene.
Ah, bath.
Now, this...
Maybe,
yeah, a bathtub. Although, where would you get the water from? Right at the top of the... But anyway, so there is this recess into the rock, and coming through here, there actually is a drain going out of it. And this very ancient construction coming around here, we can get another angle at the at this drainage point. So this is that drainage point right here. Right there, that's the drainage point. How is one to get down from this rock here? There is a basin sort of thing in the top here with a drainage hole right there. and all manner of holes and cuttings. And there are these very dainty little steps around the side to get off this rock. So they just fit the feet. Coming back down.